Look, I'm a never forget guy. I'm of the opinion that we don't see the imagery of 9/11 often enough. It seems relegated to just once a year, usually on the anniversary. But this is not what I had in mind. Thursday's New York Post cover showed images of the Twin Towers burning down on September 11, juxtaposed with a quote from Representative Ilhan Omar. The quote was from remarks she made at a March 23rd banquet hosted by the Council on American-Islamic Relations, or CARE. Her description of 9/11 as "some people did something" has now caused a firestorm. Well, here's some context.
Far too long, we have lived with the discomfort of being a second-class citizen. And frankly, I'm tired of it, and every single Muslim in this country should be tired of it. CARE was founded after 9/11 because they recognized that some people did something and that all of us were starting to lose access to our civil liberties.
Washington Post fact checker Glenn Kessler among those who pointed out that CARE was founded in 1994, not after September 11. Omar's spokesperson Jeremy Slevin said the congresswoman misspoke, meant to refer to the fact that the organization had doubled in size after the September 11th attacks. There has been a full-throated reaction from both sides of the aisle. Texas Republican Congressman and former Navy SEAL Dan Crenshaw tweeted this: first member of Congress to ever describe terrorists who killed thousands of Americans on 9/11 as "some people who did something unbelievable." Donald Trump Jr. tweeted, "This woman is a disgrace." On Fox and Friends, co-host Brian Kilmeade said this.
Really? There's some few people did something? You have to wonder if she's an American first.
Others faulted the New York Post. Michigan Democratic Representative Rashida Tlaib said taking Omar's words out of context was a pure racist act. Representative Alexandria Ocasio-Cortez was similarly appalled.
We are getting to the level where this is an incitement of violence against progressive women of color. And if they can't figure out how to get it back to policy, we need to call it out for what it is, because this is not normal, and this is not a normal level of political debate or rhetoric. As wild as it can get sometimes, this is something beyond what is normal.
The New York Post didn't back off, instead running a follow-up editorial that doubled down, saying Omar and her supporters simply want to stifle debate by declaring any criticism of her to be out of bounds, and Democrats are playing along, either echoing the out-of-context excuse or just staying silent. It's even worse than their failed effort to condemn her remarks, accusing American Jews of dual loyalty and of buying political support for Israel. The dodges may play well on Twitter, but we suspect most Americans will remain appalled. Then Congresswoman Omar made things worse with another tweet. She cited President George W. Bush's quote, "The people and the people who knock these buildings down will hear all of us soon," and asked, "Was Bush downplaying the terrorist attack? What if he was a Muslim?" By the way, I don't think the comparison is a good one. President Bush, unlike Omar, wasn't ignoring the perpetrators of 9/11. Hell, he was threatening revenge against them. And yesterday, President Trump joined the fray himself with this tweet, which incorporated grisly images of the towers with her quote. Everybody has had their say except me, so here goes. I think that at best, her words were poorly chosen. Never should anyone, much less a member of Congress, minimize September 11 by saying that some people did something. Better that in making a point about civil liberties, she had correctly noted the terrorists killed 3,000 innocent Americans, robbing them of all of their civil liberties. I can understand why she might have been uncomfortable using the words radical Islam in front of an Islamic group, but here's what she should have said. She should have said, CARE doubled in size after 9/11 because it recognized that in the aftermath of the most despicable and heinous terror attack on our country, which was perpetrated by individuals who distorted our faith, law-abiding, peace-loving Muslims were losing access to all of our civil liberties. After I made that point on Sirius XM radio, a friend of mine objected and he said, Omar's being held to a different standard because she's a Muslim. And that made me reconsider. What if it had been a different type of political leader who similarly sought to make Representative Omar's point about the curtailment of civil liberties post 9/11? After all, that's a libertarian mantra. What if a libertarian leader, maybe Ron Paul, was speaking at an affinity group like Cato and similarly said, some people did something that caused the rest of us to lose all of our civil liberties? Would he have faced the same reaction as Congresswoman Omar? Probably not.